See all this transfer talk, in particular with Celtic, it's just newspaper talk. Last year, the English market was like 800 million quid. This morning, I heard it was standing at about 60 million, and most of that was at Spurs. So if the market contracts, there's less to go around. Brendan knows, in fact, we all know as Celtic fans what we need. And if Brendan, and no one knows that better than Brendan, and if he could get some of the people in that he needs, he'd do that. The market has shrunk. It's difficult. No one's moving. And that's the bottom line. But it's the newspapers that are building this up to put pressure on the managers, which is outrageous.
Do you not think he himself, you know, said that he wanted quality players in, though? I mean, I think that's what a lot of people are referencing rather than newspaper talk.
That's such an obvious statement. Of course he wants quality players in. We as fans want quality players in. So that's just managerial talk.
I actually think maybe that is what we need. Maybe we need a deep dive into the economics of European football and how the market forces are changing and whether the market is shrinking or not. And I think you're the man, Gordon Deal, to conduct that study.
I'll go for that study.
Could you have your research
on
my desk by next week?
I liked his call. I thought he made great sense. I really did.
Because look, football's a cynical business. Paul came on and he stuck up for Celtic. And the first reply was from Stuart on Twitter, who said, "Is that Peter Lowell on the phone?" So there we go.
It did cross my mind that Paul sits on the board the way he came across. Very eloquent.
Your real name is Paul, yeah?
Yes,
good. Glad we cleared that up. Anyway, we're nearly done.
Good to chat again, fun. Peter.
You've not seen him since that since he chucked you out.
Since he ripped the contract off.
Since that small payoff that you got.